We're going to start in the room with questions. Thank you for spending some time with us today. And then we're going to hop to Zoom for a few. In the interest of time, we will not be getting to everybody today. He's got a whole bunch of stations to get to and a long day ahead. So let's start off with Tim McMahon. Go ahead.
Hey, Luka. Jason Gill was in here. He compared you to a young Picasso. He said he knew Picasso was.
Yeah, of course.
I feel offended. Though.
He said, no, you know, nobody might not have ever told Picasso to use all the paints, but he does want to remind you, you know, to rely on him to trust your teammates. What do you think about that? What do you kind of think about trusting your teammates as part of your development as the face of this franchise?
I mean, yeah, of course. Not just that. I think there's a lot of things I can improve on off the court, on the court. Obviously, this is one of them, and I think he's right. But I still got to improve a lot of things.
Wayne Price, go ahead.
Wayne Price, Mavs.com. Congratulations on your summer. The Olympics.
Thank you.
What did you learn about the game of basketball in the Olympics that you didn't already know it? How does that experience going to help you move forward?
I mean, I basically knew the game. You know, it's the same game I played in Madrid. You know, mostly the European basketball. The rules are different. You know, it's the pain is smaller. Everything is smaller. But I learned a lot. You know, I had amazing teammates. I had the whole country behind me, behind us, and we had a pretty great run. But obviously, I think the fourth place is the worst in whenever, so that's the bad thing about it.
How cool was that to lead your country to the other for the first time?
Oh, it was great, you know, especially I remember in Lithuania, it was the whole arena was for Lithuania, obviously, because we were in Lithuania, it was really hard, and they had an amazing team, so we had to fight really hard, and that day, you know, we really stepped together and won the game.
Yeah, go ahead.
In about the 6 weeks since the Olympics, what has life looked for you? How much time did you take to relax versus how much training did you get to do
beforehand? I took about 1 or 2 weeks off, just to get, you know, my mind off basketball. It was like 2 months straight, you know, basketball after the season. So I had to get my mind off a little bit and then just start practicing.
Right,
go
ahead.
Matt Towns, Dallas Morning News. It's been a few weeks, and your extension doesn't kick in until next season, but how does $207 million do?
It's great. You know, it's amazing. Yeah, I still can't believe it, you know. Like I said in a press conference, I only wanted, you know, my dream was to be able to play in the NBA, just to touch the floor, and now I'm here. You know, it's just unbelievable.
Dorothy
Gentry, iMessenger Media. Luka, what does this season mean for you? Whole new coaching staff, new teammates, new opportunity. What does it mean for you?
I mean, I'm always excited about the start of the season. You know, there's a lot of new things. I mean, especially this year, almost the whole new coaching staff, you know, some new players. And I'm really excited, you know. I think we're going to be great together.
Can I go
ahead? Yeah, just have one follow-up. I know it's a big topic in the NBA because there are some cities that unvaccinated players won't be able to play in. So I'm curious, have you been vaccinated and are you good to go on that front?
I mean, yeah. But that's I want to keep it in private, so it doesn't matter. But, you know, everybody should have their own choice of what they do.
Did you get enough time to recharge during the offseason? And have you thought about the fact that where you are, I mean, every summer it seems like there's going to be something that kind of eats into your what should be downtime.
Yeah, but obviously I didn't get enough, but, you know, I will always, when I have opportunity to play for my country, I will play. You know, it helps me stay in shape, you know, and playing for my country for me is just something unbelievable. You know, it's something you do with your heart, and I will always do it if I can.
Hey,
Luka, Chuck and Team Radio. What have you learned about leadership and your own leadership style through know, the playoff series last year with Clippers and the Olympics, and how, what does that mean to you, and how does that evolve?
I mean, I think leadership, you know, you develop it through the years. You know, you see every year he's got to be a little better, you know. Obviously, I learned from the playoffs, from the Olympics, I had to be a leader. One thing I learned is I need to be more vocal with the team.
Vocal?
Yeah. Inside the team.
One last question, Luka. Your thoughts on playing for Jason Kidd, a guy that brought a lot of excitement to this franchise when he first came here in 1994, the same thing you did when you got here in 2018?
Yeah, I think that it's amazing. You know, it's a great opportunity for me, you know, to learn from a guy that was a champion here as a player, playing the same position as me. You know, he was one of the best passers in the NBA, and I'm really excited about it.
All right, we're going to jump to Zoom really quickly for a couple. Mike Shapiro, you can start us off.
Hi, Luka. Mike Shapiro, Sports Illustrated. What impresses you about Kristaps' skill set, and why do you think that you two can be, you know, an effective combo together and one of the best combos in the league?
I mean, first of all, he's 220. I don't know. Whatever, 220 centimeters. I don't know. And he can make almost every shot, you know. I think he's in way better shape this year, especially mentally. You can see him having a good time when we were playing pickup. And I think he's going to have a great season this year.
Thank you.
Have a great.
Hey, Luka, good to see you this offseason, ready for this new season here. For you, you talked about this summer, the chemistry that you experienced with the Slovenia team and how you want to see that grow with your own team this year. How do you think that will grow as you guys learn under Jason Kidd and what that chemistry and what you want to see this year?
I think we'll be good, you know. We got to maybe hang out with each other, you know, more. That's what we're doing with the Slovenian national team. Basically, we're together all the time. I mean, I know it was different circumstances because we were in the hotel all the time, but, you know, I think this year we'll be better.
All right, Davide.
Hi, Luka. Davide Chinellato here from Gazzetta. You're probably the MVP favorite this season. Do you see yourself that way? And what's the goal for the season, for the team?
I don't care about that. It's only the beginning of the season. That's at the end, that's far away, but my goal is, I mean, the team goal and my goal is to win the championship. That's it.
All right, today, huh?
Zdravo, Luka, tudi je Lampred Pop TV. Vedno pravite, vaš cilj je vedno naslov prvaka. Kaj je tisto, kar se vam zdi, da morate vi osebno in pa moštvo izboljšati, da boste bližje temu cilju oziroma da ga boste dosegli?
Mislim, da je veliko stvari za zboljšati. Tudi osebno je veliko stvari za zboljšati. Koliko je ekipa, kot prvo, koliko vsi govorijo, kemija naše ekipe, mora biti na pravem mestu. Ampak mislim, da bo letos zelo boljš in upam na to, da bo tudi zelo boljš.
Nemanja?
Zdravo, Luka. Pozdrav iz Beograda. Reci mi, kako izgleda igranje, to je sa Bobanom Marjanovićem, šta si video, kako izgleda sada kada se vratio, kako ti sve to deluje? I reci mi, u Igoru Kokošku, eto, vratio se, ponovo ćete sarađivati zajedno, jeste li razgovarali, šta očekujete od neke vaše zajedničke saradnje tu u novoj sezoni?
Da, meni je s Bobanom super igrat. Kad igramo pick and roll, samo baciš gore i daje koš, tako da to je nešto najlažije. I sa Igorom, da, super što je došao. Imamo mnogo, non-stop smo u kontaktu, tako da i on mislim da je sretan što je sad ovdje. All right,
we're going to take two more in Warren. Barra. Barra.
Hey, hello, Luka. Burak from Trend Basket. What are you looking to learn is the most important thing from the coach kid?
I'm looking to learn a lot from him, you know. Like I said before, he was one of the best passers in the world. He was a great leader too, so I think I can learn from him a lot of things.
All right, thank you. Leonardo.
Luka, ¿qué tal? Te saluda Leonardo Torres desde Perú. Espero que estés bien. Luca, ¿cuán emocionado estás de jugar para Jason Kidd y qué es lo que esperas desarrollar en esta temporada? Gracias.
Estoy muy emocionado. Como he dicho antes en inglés, creo que ha sido un jugador increíble, uno de los mejores pasadores de la historia de este juego y un gran líder, así que creo que aprendí muchísimo de él.
Hey, Luka, Mark Caldwell, Mavs TV. Good to talk to you. I noticed that you just got asked a question about Igor Prokoshkov. I was wondering if you could share with us what it's like to be reunited and how excited it is to be back with Igor, given your past with him.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really excited. You know, he was the coach that we won a year basket, the first medal for our country. You know, he was a great coach. He helped everybody. Everybody liked him. So I'm really excited that he's here.
All right,
I'll
do it.
Thank you.
Spend some time with us, Luka.
Thank you.
Good summer for Pogacar and Roglic.
Yeah,
for Pogacar and Roglic.
Oh, yeah,
good
yeah,
summer.
Yeah.
He's gonna get you. Guys, we'll keep you posted on who comes next. I honestly have no clue. So.
Hey, Pete.
This is Wayne.